Hi, everyone, and welcome back to this episode of AI in the Enterprise. And I want to take a topic that I think is really key because it talks to data and analytics. And with everything that's going on with the pandemic, one of the realizations I have is that every one of us in all walks of life is getting more familiar with the concept of data and insights that come off of it. I mean, all of us are literally waking up to dashboards, whether it's the virus or the spread or other economic derivatives of that. We're all getting used to looking at that. And as that permeates itself across the general population, a lot of that is coming into play for large enterprises. One of the discussions I have often with many of you as we've interacted over the last few weeks in the enterprise is the need and the imperative, the criticality of data and analytics. And I thought I'd use this opportunity today to actually unpeel that. I am frequently told that analytics professionals across the globe have never been busier ever before. And if that's really true, then I want to unpeel where is all the effort going in and what are the imperatives and things that are being worked on. To do that, I want to invite back Amaresh Tripathy. Now, some of you know Amaresh from having been here on the show before. Amaresh heads analytics for Genpact globally across all of our geographies, but he's also an adjunct professor at the UNC campus in Charlotte, where he is involved in the data science program. And across that work, the work he does with us, and then obviously in our interactions with all of you, I think there's some great insights. And I wanted to just bring him on and unveil this topic. So with that, Amaresh, welcome. Thank you for being here.
Always a pleasure to be back, Sanjay. Lovely chatting with you.
Awesome. And Amaresh, you saw the tee up I did for the topic at hand, but I think if you had a few words to sort of capture the essence of analytics today, what would that be?
I'll say it's a tale of two cities, Sanjay. On one end, if you really, for someone who's spent 20 years in this helping organizations build decisions based on data, it's disappointing about like as a society, how much data, how much information we are making on gut feel versus data. I mean, overall, if I go and look back. But the flip side of it, if you're an analytics leader, if you're an analytics professional right now, the time is now, right? It's the opportunities right now. People are hungry. I mean, you wake up to a dashboard, so does everyone else, but they also want to wake up to dashboards around their cash positions, around the supply chain, around their customer sentiments, all kinds of dashboards and insights. So folks are hungry for data and insights, and they're willing to embrace. So if you're an analytics professional, that's why you're busy, because the time is now.
Amaresh, I would think that also with us, all of us going into this work from home environment, we're no longer sitting in these multi-story kind of downtown locations with, you know, a swarm of people around us that we can walk up to very quickly and ask a question or the other. And as we move into this distributed environment, we're all working from home. Isn't that need for that core information and data just super high? And isn't that driving part of what's happening in the enterprise?
A part of it, yes. But I think even more is because we haven't seen anything like before. Our mental models, our demand model, all kind of models that were relevant 3 weeks ago, 5 weeks ago, are no longer relevant. So we are all kind of like struggling to find what is the baseline, right? So that I think, and that obviously is just getting exacerbated by the fact that now you are not even working with your colleagues on a day-to-day, you can't bounce off ideas that easily. So both of that is creating an anxiety and a hunger for, okay, like some sort of a baseline and stability and some numbers.
So you actually expanded the point, right? You said not only is data analytics something that we're all using now and getting more and more used to, you're actually saying that the models need to improve and get better because the sophistication that's required with all things that have changed is different. Tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, actually, even before sophistication, what is required is the new baseline. The first thing that is required, what is the immediate transparency around what is the baseline today, which I know is not relevant from 3 weeks ago, right? My demand patterns, I was talking to a client, they were like their demand patterns of like a store SKU level kind of a demand is completely different because everyone is buying in a very different way, right? There are certain, I mean, you know, you made a trip to Costco, you probably made a trip to a grocery store and you kind of loaded up on certain things and others. And everyone is doing that. So demand pattern has changed, so they don't know how to kind of react to that. What does that baseline even look like? If you do that, then the second question is, what is the next demand model is potentially could be, right? Like, how do you predict it? And that requires, of course, sophistication. And sophistication not because I need the better models, I actually need newer data, right? Because when did my state go to stay shelter at home? At what rate the disease is progressing? That is equally relevant right now compared to like just my statistical models of what actually had happened. So it's better data, more data, better modeling. That's also is required. So it's a little bit more nuanced than more sophisticated models.
One of the things, Amaresh, it strikes me that the COVID-19 situation has done is it's actually ended up becoming the ultimate test for digitization of a company. In other words, everyone believes that they're digitizing at whatever level they have. But COVID has actually tested the boundaries of that, particularly if you go into work from home environments. Are you really set up for that? And those of us, those companies that are there are probably 100% digitized, and there are many, many companies that aren't quite there. Is there a similar way of thinking around analytics and data? How much of the data is truly available? How much of these new modeling techniques are in play? And what can you tell us that we can use in our sort of approach to solving for this?
Yeah, I mean, like I go back to the Warren Buffett statement, like when the water goes down in the swimming pool, you know who's swimming naked, right? It's partly when there's a lot of growth and secular growth, whether you invest in data or not invest in data, you will get the growth, right? Right now, what we are seeing is it's essentially there are two types of companies that I come across. Those who have invested in their data foundation, their data strategies, and build the data lakes, who are able to very quickly slice and dice the data, right? And adjust to the new norm very, very quickly. And they can go and project 50 different scenarios for tomorrow in like 3 days, versus the companies that are struggling, where are their employees to wear? Where are the masks to? Where are the equipments? The basic level things, it takes them a few days to kind of come to across. And that speed of decision making that is required, the chances that if you have invested in the first one, you will come ahead of it once this all everything is over here.
Okay, but all is not lost. I mean, if I'm one of those companies that didn't make all those investments and wasn't fully set up, I mean, what's your advice to me? What's your advice to that company and say, here's number one, here's number two, here's one, two, three things you could be doing right now?
And again, you're 100% right. But the way the things you have to do, and even if you have invested, I think you have to do those things, go and help out, go and engage with the businesses who are decision makers, who are making decisions, help them with transparency, right? Collect the data, you have people, there's some investment, some technology, there's a lot of open source there, but like bring whatever assets you have today, okay? And try to put the data together and to give them the new baseline. Everyone wants the new baseline. Number two, once you give them the baseline, they all have very specific questions. They need targeted insights, right? Whether it's a better demand forecast, whether it's understanding of consumer sentiment on a particular topic, they would have specific questions. So go and provide them targeted insights on those questions that you will only get them once you kind of give them the transparency. And third, it's the world is rapidly changing, right? I mean, there's a banking company the bank that I know who want to look at which direct deposits are falling off, continuously monitor direct deposit falling off because that is a risk on their lending portfolio, right? So how do you actually provide the continuous monitoring, because the world is changing literally on an hourly basis right now. So how do you kind of set that up? So once these are the three things you have, if you have an analytics leader, you have to go and provide those three things. And coming out of it, let's 3 months, 6 months, once things stabilize a little bit, I think it's a good time to reflect and see what foundational investments you need to find, then go and make.
So I want to come to coming out of it in a second. If I got this right, look, right now, here and now, we got to deal with the situation, and we'll come to the other one in a bit. And you're saying, number one, get the basics on data and transparency out so everyone's got the insights. Number two, focus on key decisions you need to make and drive insights to allow you to make those decisions.
Yes.
And the third one is the world has changed. And in that change world, monitoring, governance, ongoing sort of tuning become really important. I saw an example of that where some of the patterns that we're seeing in one part of the world applying to another part of the world in a week to 2 weeks to come. So if you're in the consumer business, those insights and transporting that insights become really important. Those are three here and now things that I hear your call to action. Any inputs on any stumbling blocks or what to watch out for? I expect change management is a large part of this, right?
Actually, it's a lot less. That's why the time is now, right? Because people are willing, right? I mean, change management is fundamentally a human thing where people are not willing to change. Right now, there is no other option but to change, right?
So actually, it's interesting because you're really saying here's an opportunity that you're never going to get again if you're in the analytics business. Use it, and gets set up better for the future.
Gets exactly. There's no better time than now, right now, if you're an analyst.
Okay. So that brings us into the future. So what do we do as we come out of it? What are the things you want us to start thinking about?
I think two things. Number one is some of the foundational investments, right? Most of them have made foundational investments somewhere in the process of making, but it's always hard to justify foundational investments, right? It's because you have to go and do this. I don't think coming out of this, if you look back of how companies are doing, that will be a hard thing to do. We just went through a very challenging time. Why you need some of the foundational investments to kind of do this. So I think life will become a little bit easier. Second is ways of working, right? The siloed approach of IT versus data versus business. How do you think about this whole agile way of operating and kind of as one team? Those are the two things I think that will have long-term impacts on this. But those are the two things you should be thinking about.
Amaresh, it's a fantastic summary. And if I got you right, you're saying it's an imperative. The time is now. This is the time to get analytics set up for the right way in the future. You're saying focus on a core infrastructure of data and visibility, transparency. Get the right support for decision-making that's going to be critical in the organizations around us, and then actually make sure that you are building out a core set of processes and dashboards and governance to be able to manage in a high transition, fast-moving world. But equally, as you're doing that, make sure that you're planning for the future as you come out of it and pay importance to making the right investments that set you up properly for the days to come. I don't think I could have said it any better. Thank you for taking the time to share with us. We're going to keep this dialogue going on LinkedIn. So I'm assuming we're going to get some back and forth on questions and answers that come up. And I look forward to that. I want to turn to my audience and say thank you for taking the time to be with us today. And Amaresh, back to you. Thanks for all you do and great spending time with you.
Thank you so much, Sanjay. It was always fun.
Bye for now.